What's up? Paul here from We Grow Hydroponics. We're going to do a step-by-step guide on how to take clones with Rockwool today for you. First things first, some preparation we got to do before we're going to take clones. So we want our ambient environment. We want mid-70s and about 50% humidity for our room around. We don't want to be on a cold surface. Some people use a heat mat, which causes cubes to dry out a little bit faster. You can just use a towel or a thick piece of cardboard like I have here to get you off that cold surface. Since we're using Rockwool, you're going to want to pre-soak Rockwool at a 5.5 pH. Baby cubes you can do for about 20 to 30 minutes before you're going to take your cuts. We're also using a 2-foot, 24-watt T5 light here. So we got our tray and dome clean, set up, ready, not on a cold surface, light, pre-soaked cubes. Alright, so now that we got that all set up, we're going to go ahead and get our cubes ready before we take our cuts. Okay, real important, don't squeeze the cube. It's going to change the consistency of the rock wool. You just want to hold it carefully, give it a nice 4 or 5 good shakes so that there's no dripping water on any corner. A little bit there. No dripping water on any corners. You're going to do this to all 20 or 30. And if you've done it right and you want to check for this, you want to make sure there's no standing water in the tray when you're done. All the water should remain in the cubes. Alright, so when you're taking your cuts, you want to make sure that you're taking from new growth tips. So something like this here. And we have another one here. Okay, so next thing you want to do to prepare these cuts, this is our new growth we just took. You want to remove all this growth off the bottom and create our stalk. You're going to go ahead and remove everything except the top two. We'll go ahead and leave those little ones. There's one. And there's two. And lastly, go ahead and make a 45 degree angle cut at the bottom here. This is going to give you the most surface area for promoting roots. So we have our nice little 45 degree angle cuts. Alright, we got our rooting hormone here. So go ahead and put those 45 degree cut tips in there. Doesn't have to be crazy, you can even tap off the excess. And we're going to go straight into our cube. If these holes that are pre-cut into your cubes are too loose, or you can always go off to the side and make your own hole. Alright, after you've got them in their homes, again, regardless of how many cuts you've taken, you have all your cubes in. Put your dome on, turn on your light. This light is going to stay on 24 hours a day. Does not need to go off. All you need to do from here on out, you're going to come in once a day. You're going to shake off. There should be condensation built up on all four sides of this dome. If there isn't missing on a side, you need to make sure you don't have cold air or something hitting it. Condensation on all four sides. You're going to take off the dome. You're going to shake off all that excess condensation. Put your dome back on. Dry up any standing water that might be in the tray. Go ahead and dry that up. And that's pretty much it. Once a day, shaking off the condensation. When you first start to see, in about 4 to 5 days, start checking for signs of roots. And also check the weight of the cubes and see if they might need some water. If you have to add water, you're going to add the water directly to the cube. No standing water in the tray. And if you are starting to see signs of roots, you can go ahead and start to crack the domes on top of the crack the vents on top of the dome, and then you're going to crack them open more and more each day. After that, once they've been all the way open for a day, then you can start taking the dome off for a few hours a day. Add a couple hours each day. After you have roots and you've been taking the dome off and you can leave it off for a whole day, they're ready for transplant.